In the previous movie, we used the modeling toolkit to adjust the shape and topology of our jacket mesh. In this movie, we'll create its UV map, as well as give the jacket some thickness. Make sure to set the current project to the provided scene folder, then open the file Jacket Modeling Part 4 Start. Think of a UV map as a flat 2D mapping, like a cloth, wrapped around your 3D models. The UV map provides Maya the necessary information to accurately display a 2D image or texture on your mesh. For more information on the basics of UV mapping, you can refer to our Unfolding a UV Mesh tutorial series. During the modeling process, it often pays to think about UV layouts earlier rather than later. Oftentimes, the UV process comes at the end of the modeling process. However, in this particular case, it will be easier to create the UVs before extruding a layer of thickness from the jacket faces. Let's start by creating a set of UVs for the torso. First, make sure you're in Viewport 2.0. Now in Face Selection mode, select all the faces pertaining to the jacket torso and collar. Remember that you can use symmetry to speed up the selection process. Click the Planar Mapping button in the Modeling shelf. Maya displays a frame representing how it projects the UVs onto the selected object. To get a better idea of how the 2D map is being wrapped around our model, let's apply a checker pattern. Select the torso and open the UV editor. Click the Display Checkered Tiles button. As you can see, the checker pattern on the side of the torso is nice and uniform, but hideously stretched across the chest. This is because by default, Maya projects the image from the side. However, our goal is to have this pattern adjusted across the entire torso. Select the jacket and go to the channel box. In the Poly Panel Proj input, set the projection's rotate Y to 0. To make the projection easier to see in the UV editor, select the UVs on both sleeves and move them out of the way for now, so that only the torso is in the UV space. Then turn off the checker pattern and click the Dim Texture button. As you can see, the projection is now casted from the front instead of the side. This provides a better starting point for us. As we demonstrated in our Unfolding a UV Mesh tutorial series, we next need to unfold the UV map so it can lie flat to ease the texturing process afterward. To unfold the UVs of a mesh like this, we need to cut a few seams first, just like a tailor would in order to lay down his garment flat on his workbench. Select these edge loops running along both sides of the torso. These will form our seam. In the UV editor, go to Polygons, Cut UV Edges. At first, nothing seems to have happened. However, turn on Texture Borders. All edges defining UV borders are now bolded, including the new ones you just created. Now hold the right mouse button and switch to UV selection mode. Select all the torso UVs. Go to Polygons, Unfold, Options. There are two methods here we can use to unfold the UVs. In this case, we're going to use Unfold 3D. We'll also turn off the Pack option, which determines whether the entire UV mesh is unfolded or just selected UVs. In this case, we want only the selected UVs unfolded. Maya unfolds the UVs, but notice the odd shape. How exactly is this supposed to represent a jacket? If you look closely, you'll notice that this is happening because of the UV borders in the front of the jacket, which are causing the UVs to fly out horizontally while the back remains one piece. This UV layout makes it difficult to create a texture. Ideally, we prefer both the front and back of the jacket to look uniform. Return to the workspace. To create better UVs, let's temporarily close the jacket to fix the UV alignment. Select the edges along one side of the open jacket by selecting the first edge and shift double-clicking the last edge. Because symmetry mode is still active, this selects the edges on both sides. In the modeling toolkit, click the bridge tool. This tool creates new faces connecting the selected edges, thus closing the hole. Make sure that divisions is set to 0. Now return to the UV editor. Select all the UVs and once again go to Polygons Unfold. This time we get a much more even 2D UV mapping. You can now delete the temporary bridged faces. Let's also separate the collar area UVs into their own UV shell, since it will be easier to paint a texture for a straight collar than a round one. Select the edge loop representing the rim of the collar and cut the UV edges. Then select its UVs and move them aside. Unfold them. To straighten out the UVs even more, select the top row of UVs and click the Align to Maximum V Value button. This will align all the selected UVs to the highest one. Do the same for the lower UVs. Feel free to align them horizontally as well. Click the Toggle Shaded UV Display button to inspect our UVs for overlapping or inversion. Red faces indicate UVs that are facing the wrong direction, while darker faces indicate places where the UV mesh overlaps. Light blue indicates the faces are fine. Since all the faces are light blue, we can move these two UV shells to the side for now and begin working on the sleeves UV mapping. Select the sleeve's faces and create a cylindrical mapping rotated 90 degrees in the Z-axis. Scale the projection to roughly fit the arms. If you turn the checker pattern back on, you can see that the UVs are currently pretty stretched. Don't worry about fixing them just yet. However, a larger concern is where the cylindrical projection has put our seam. It doesn't line up with the seam we made for the torso. Select all the seams across the length of the arm. In the UV editor, go to Polygons, Sew UV Edges. The edges are no longer bolded, indicating they're not UV borders anymore. Select the edge loop under the arm that lines up with those of the torso, and cut those edges instead. Now you can select all the sleeve's UVs and use the Unfold tool to unfold them. Once again, use the basic transform tools to arrange them on the UV plane. Notice that the UV shells are irregularly shaped. Technically, we could work with this if we really wanted to, since the shaded display shows only blue faces, but it'd be difficult to create an even texture for such an odd shape. UV meshing is usually about balancing an even shape that's easy to create a 2D texture for, while also avoiding distortions from stretching the UVs too far. Start by selecting all the UVs along the top of the left sleeve UV shell. Like the collar, use the Align to Maximum V button to straighten them out. Continue this for each successive UV loop. You can do the same for the vertical UV loops as well. When you're done, use the checker pattern to ensure the UV mapping isn't too warped. Tweak individual UVs in the UV texture editor as necessary to get a nice even pattern. Repeat the entire process for the right sleeve. Now that your jacket has a useful UV layout, let's finalize this mesh by giving it some thickness. In face selection mode, double-click the mesh to select all its faces. In the modeling toolkit, use the extrude tool and pull the faces out 0.3 units in the local Z-axis. Make sure divisions is set to 1. This creates our outer layer. Now because we laid out our UV shell for the inner layer, it will be easy to reuse that work for the outer layer. Just double-click a face on the torso, switch the selection to UVs, then go to the Move tool. As you can see, we can strip out the outer face UVs instantly. However, notice that in UV shaded mode, they're colored red, meaning the faces are pointing in the wrong direction. Use these buttons to flip them in the U or V direction to fix this. Repeat this process for the other UV shells. With the individual UV shells finished, you can now lay them out in the UV space. In general, you want the areas of highest scrutiny to take up the most space, like the outer layer, while lesser seen areas, like the inner layer, can be smaller and therefore less detailed. For a little added flair, you can also extrude the lower faces of the jacket and the first face loop around each sleeve to represent the jacket's weighted rim and sleeves respectively. Once your UV setup is finished, select the mesh and go to Polygon's UV Snapshot to export the UV layout to an image file at the resolution of your choice. Then import this image into your favorite image editor to create a texture for the jacket. Remember that what we've shown you in this series are basic techniques for creating any base geometry mesh. You can apply the same principles to create any number of other models, clothing or otherwise.